I'm gonna make it simple for you. I'm gonna show you what's the best lures to use and buy. I mean.
And I'll stay here and move that.
Okay. Now, a lot of these lures you see, crankbaits, square bills, some of the deals I show you, some of them out there might be just as good. I just never have used one. Okay. I'm just gonna show you what I use, what I know works. And I know I wouldn't buy anything else except what works. And that's what you came to hear. I know if I was a young fisherman or an avid fisherman like you are, and you go in a store and there's 10 kinds of square bills, well, I'm going to tell you which one you need to buy and the hell with the rest of them, okay? But anyhow, I'm going to show you my favorite crankbaits and tell you how I use them, what colors work best. Okay, color's always very important. And I'm gonna start with the small ones first, the ones that catch the most fish. They design what I call Little Mr. Money. And the reason it's called Little Mr. Money is because I made a ton of money on this little bait. All right, besides Walmart, Strike King, and tournaments, I won a lot of money on them. It wasn't what won the tournament for me, but it catches lots of fish. And I've seen times I'd be fishing like this big square bill balsa bee I'm gonna talk about that I won a couple of BASSs on. And it'd get down to where I had 30 minutes or an hour to go and I'd pick up this little thing and start throwing it around and I'd catch me a limit of small ones to go with those big ones, and that's how you win sometimes. But this is called Little Mr. Money. Only place you can buy it's Walmart. Little bitty crankbait, probably without the bill, it's not more than an inch long. You think it doesn't throw good? I throw it on a bait caster a long ways. It's got a little weight to it. Wonder what color hooks are those?
Red
hooks. Wonder why they put them on there. I told them they had to. It was the number one selling bait that Walmart had in the sporting goods for 2 years. Why? It catches the heck out of them. Brim, crappie, bass, you catch everything on it because it resembles a little bitty minnow, and that's why it catches a lot of fish. And there's times we have tournaments that I have to go to the little bitty crankbaits to catch numbers of fish, just like the little money. These are little bitty square bills, and I've caught a lot of fish on these. And you know, I've even seen people go in a bay and fish four or five laydown logs and wait my turn and go in there and catch five or six right behind them. These little suckers will catch them. Hear it? Hear the rattlers in it? These baits are old. Here's my two favorite colors. One's a brim color. Boy, I've caught a lot of fish on this. I can remember tournaments after tournaments after tournaments. I got checks, 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 checks. I hadn't won any on them. By golly, I was in the top 10 a lot, and I finished way up, and that's fishing against the best day in and day out. They're called Little O's.
Who makes them?
Cordell. Here's a shad-colored one, and here's a brim-colored one. If I can't catch anything after 3 days of practice, I go deep. But that's my last resort, and the reason why is I'm comfortable finding an area fishing 10 foot or less most of the places I go. And I've proven that you can make a good living doing it for 35 years. Okay, now we're gonna get a little deeper, okay? I'm looking at these little baits here. They're called a Series 1. Strike King makes it. Bandit makes one just like it, little square bill. These are bigger than the ones I'm talking about. I've won tournaments on these. They're a little bit bigger. If you look, they're about 2.5, almost 3 inches long. They run about 5 foot deep at the most. That's with about 12 pounds. Most time I'm fishing, because I'm fishing heavy cover with these usually. Most crankbaits I fish, you're looking at this diagram right here at the bottom. That's what I'm looking for. When you throw a crankbait, you don't throw it out there and just crank it, you're throwing around something all the time. Bass live around cover that you see right here. My three favorite kind of wood things that I'm looking for is lay down logs, stumps, corner of boat docks, and I could go on and on, bushes, and I mean I want it to come in and bounce off of it. That's what the square bills are designed for. When it comes up to something and it hits it, it varies off of it. That's when they hit it. You can throw all day long around cover, and when they're really biting, you'll catch some. But if you're throwing at a stump, let's say this box is a stump right here, I can throw down this side, I can throw down this side, but if I throw and it comes over there and bumps off of it, if there's one there, he's gonna get it.
Hey, I'm Pete Gluzek.
And I'm Mike Iaconelli.
And this is Bass University TV.
Welcome to Bass University TV, an online video training course where you'll learn champion bass fishing techniques from pro anglers Pete Gluzek, Mike Iaconelli, and their talented special guests.
Everywhere I go in the country, I'm trying to use these techniques because I catch big fish that way.
From on the water to in the classroom.
We want to use that bait to help make that area even smaller and really, really find that sweet spot.
You'll learn sound techniques and strong fundamental bass fishing skills.
You want something that's got a nice limber action, that's gonna allow you to build pressure and keep those hooks pinned against that fish's mouth.
Watch hours of video content on multiple topics at your own pace for a low monthly fee. Cancel at any time.
Hold on, because you're gonna catch some big fish.
Information is power in the sport of fishing, so learn from the very best.
That's a key theory in all of fishing.
Subscribe to Bass University TV today.
Man, does it trigger a lot of strikes.
Here's the part that you're not going to hear anywhere else. This is the Bass University TV exclusive.